Hey guys, what's up? Check it out. It's Qbert. Qbert was one of the original arcade video games from the 1980s, and Qbert jumps. So in comparison, this is folded from 6-inch Kami, and it jumps like this. This one is folded from 3-inch Kami, and it jumps a lot nicer. Just like that. And I'm sure you guys all want me to teach this pyramid, but let me tell you, it is super complex, and I'm going to teach it. So stay tuned. And now I'm going to show you how to fold this Qbert. Ready, set, here goes. So for this model, I'm going to use a 6-inch square of Kami. That way the legs will look separate. If you use printer paper, it'll just look like one giant leg. All right, so begin white side up and fold in half. Try to make really precise folds and crease sharply. Unfold and fold to the crease. And repeat. And unfold and fold to this crease. And repeat. And fold this edge to this edge. Crease it sharply and unfold and repeat. And unfold, turn over and fold these two corners to these two points where the creases touch the edges. And unfold and turn over top to bottom and push in this point, and now form a water bomb base by holding here and folding in like this and squash. And now fold the two corners to the top. Fold these two corners down. And unfold, and now fold these two flaps to the middle of the square. Crease those sharply. And unfold. And now we're going to reverse fold them. So open here and push this point in on the two creases. So that one's easy. And this one needs to be reversed. So pinch like that. And flatten. Open here and repeat. All right, so this is what it looks like. And now fold these two corners to the crease. Unfold and fold this edge to the crease. And repeat. So the flaps will overlap. And rotate. And now insert one of the flaps into the pocket of the other. So right like that. It doesn't matter which pocket, but I'm going for the colored one. And now fold this flap over. Crease that sharply. And bend just to make sure that they stay locked together. And now we're going to curve this flap so that this becomes a circle. So just curve it, wrap it around, shape it, sculpt it, and repeat. And if you curve it enough, when you let go, it should just stay as a circle. So right now I haven't curved it enough. So I'm going to continue curving it. That's getting better. And this side, they can overlap a little bit. And then when you let go, now they almost stay. Yeah, that's pretty good. It doesn't need to be closed down here. It's really, the view is from up here. Like that. Okay. All right, now let's fold these two flaps like this. And unfold, and now we're going to reverse them. So push in like this, and repeat. And now push this flap in, and repeat. Turn over and fold this edge to the crease. And repeat. And just to give it a little bit better jump mechanism, fold this flap to the edge. And repeat. So we're just making it thicker. And turn over, and now we're going to fold this edge in. This is to taste. You can fold it in so that the fold goes all the way in there. We're just narrowing the legs. Okay, fold this flap, the whole flap, on this point. Yeah, you don't need to fold too strong there. Now we're going to make the feet. So this is to taste. However big you want the feet is fine. The bigger they are, the easier it will be to stand on the feet. But I don't know, I'm gonna make it like this big, like that. And you don't need to fold very sharply here. And now, with this remaining length, we're going to divide it into thirds. So make a pleat here and here. And again, don't make sharp folds. We're just bending it once and again. And it doesn't need to be perfect thirds. But it's best if these two points align. That way it'll jump up more. If it's over like this, it'll probably jump forward, and if it's further like that, it'll probably jump backwards. So just try to keep these two points equal. Okay, so that's good. And now blow it up. Oh, and you blow it right into this hole. And just form it into a ball. You could make it the cube, because hey, it's called Qbert, but actually Qbert is really ball-shaped. It's the cubes that he jumps on that are why it's called Qbert. Okay, and now just put your finger right here and press down, and yeah. If you press it down and hold too long, then it'll probably lose its jumping ability pretty soon. Ooh, that was a good one. All right, have fun folding your Qbert and see you later.